also bruises on her back. For God's sake, Joe, they've been married 12 years.
All right. I'll have an arrest warrant out for Alberti before he can put down another six-pack, all right? Hey, stick around.
I have a deposition.
There's something we need to talk about. Just came in this morning.
Providence, Rhode Island?
The DA up there is a good friend of Marino's. He's been looking for someone outside his office to head his domestic violence bureau. Go ahead, open.
I don't understand.
Well, what's not to understand? You've got an impressive record. Marino's word is like gold with the guy. He wants you in Providence a week from yesterday.
I'm very flattered, but this is very sudden, isn't it?
Well, yeah, like everything else in life. But we're not just talking about a promotion here. We're talking about a quantum leap in your career. Go ahead, read the job profile. You'd be coordinating everything from counseling services to court appearances. That's right up your alley, kiddo.
Joe.
Not to mention a 50% salary hike minimum, which I know to you isn't exactly a top priority, but it would certainly make me smile. Look, nobody knows better than me how good you've been for this office. But let's be honest. Here, you're just another foot soldier. Anonymous and underpaid.
I'll need some time.
Fine. Only Marino needs to know by tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Kathy, look. You don't say no to this kind of job because it doesn't come up again. Not like this. And if it does, it won't be for a long time.
Well, if you ask me, we should be celebrating at 21 over Dom Perignon, as opposed to having this great debate over a couple of Diet Pepsis.
I don't know, Edie. It's just more complicated.
It is.
Leaving my father's firm was easy, you know? I felt it. This is different.
You made your list yet?
What list?
You know, your list, where you take the issue, you write out the pros and cons. A little trick my therapist taught me.
Does it work?
For $75 an hour, it better work. Okay. We know it's the right career move. So we must consider the emotional / romantic side of things.
What are those?
Well, let's face it, for 8 million people, New York is a hell of a lonely place. Who knows? Maybe a new city would be good for you. Give you a chance to meet somebody worthwhile.
Maybe.
Okay, I know what to do. We chill a couple of days until the right decision comes to you.
Marino needs an answer by tomorrow.
Nice of him to let you sleep on it. This is a hard one, huh? If you want, I know this astrologer. Have you ever heard of Madame Sharonova?
I don't think so, Edie. If I do decide to go, I'm gonna miss you.
I know. Who else you gonna get to do all your work?
This is the best shot. Extraordinary, isn't it? You have something more?
You can't seriously expect me to go to the provost with this, Edward.
A research team? Funding? For what? Our own Loch Ness monster? I'd be laughed out of the office.
I'm not asking for a grant.
I know you're not.
I'm asking for a week, maybe two. In our own backyard.
I'm sorry.
But you saw the evidence.
A 4-second video clip and some inconclusive enlargements?
I was there, Leland. I saw the creature. I looked into his eyes.
You're wasting your time imagining things.
At least I'm not blind to them.
Forgive me, I didn't mean that. You're here largely because this university has chosen to humor you.
This university owes me something.
We owe you nothing. You haven't published in God knows how long. You're still full of self-pity because someone else received the credit for your work 15 years ago. Stole the credit. Well, I'm sorry, Edward, but it's ancient history.
You look like an angel standing there.
I wanted to see you. I have a decision to make. And I need your help. I've been offered another job, Vincent. A much better job. With more responsibility, chance to use my training, and to help people more than I'm able to now. But it would mean leaving New York.
Where would you go?
Providence, Rhode Island.
Providence is when something is meant to be.
I don't know what's meant to be. Vincent, I care about you so deeply. But a part of me is unhappy. And we both know why.
Well, then you don't have any choice.
But I do. That's why I'm here.
You didn't come this far, Catherine, to turn back now.
I came this far because of you. I don't want to leave you behind.
Beyond these tunnels, beyond this city, is a world of possibilities and wonders and things calling out to be done. These things I could only dream about until you came into my life. Catherine, don't you understand? You must go. You must see. You must do everything you were meant to do. For me, for both of us. Be with you. Always.
There's no other way.
No. Not for us.
Oh, you look terrific.
You look pretty good yourself.
The Alberti case, believe it or not. The guy's got a pair of pit bulls for attorneys. But we'll beat him.
We were a pretty good team, weren't we? Going to Providence, Joe. What?
I don't know. I guess I was kind of half hoping you'd go the other way.
Yesterday, you said...
Yeah, I know what I said yesterday. I even meant it. I'm not too crazy about losing you.
Thanks, Joe, for everything.
You made the right call, right, Cliff? I'm gonna miss you. Vincent, the pain you feel now will lessen in time and finally pass. That I promise.
So the best I can hope for is to forget her. Forget everything. Mine was another life before Catherine. I'm changed. Forever.
All right. Then accept the change. Learn from it. You must let the woman follow her own path. Vincent, for your sake.
Those are just words, Father. Shadows of feelings. They offer no consolation.
Vincent!
I'm in.
Professor Hughes.
Yes?
My name's Jonathan Gould. I'm a grad student. I'm in your section this semester.
Yes, how can I help you?
You may have that backward. I was here yesterday, in your office, dropping off a paper. Leland Quint is a fool. Do you mind if I sit?
So, what is your interest in this matter exactly?
The truth. I'm only interested in finding out the truth.
Truth is an abstraction.
Yes, but that creature is no abstraction. It's real, isn't it?
I appreciate your enthusiasm, Mr. Gould. I once felt that way myself, believe me. Probably before you were born. But I think it would be wise to forget it.
I can't do that. Think of what you saw. And what it would mean.
I've already jeopardized what little is left of my career. Take my advice, you're young. Don't make the same mistakes I did.
I guess I'm wasting my time.
You don't understand. There's, no support, no funding.
With all due respect, Professor Hughes, I do understand. That's why I'm here.
light.
For Catherine.
Love's light wings did I o'erperch these walls, for stony limits cannot hold love out. Vincent.
Message said it was urgent.
Vincent is missing. He's been gone since the night before last.
I saw him that night.
I know.
Is there somewhere he might have gone?
No, he would never cause me such undue worry. We've searched everywhere. He's nowhere below.
Vincent was not himself after he spoke with you.
About my going away. Doing what we both thought best.
Once I thought I knew the answer. No longer. We must find Vincent. Quickly.
What can we do?
Our friends above are searching the city. Beyond that, I don't know.
Why did you come to tell me?
Because I know you care.
Tranquilizer seems to be wearing off. Heartbeat still constant. 21 beats a minute. Remarkable. His lungs are just as powerful. The blood is so highly oxygenated. He's a miracle. Like nothing I even dreamed of. Jonathan, we saw him running. Complete bipedal locomotion. That can only suggest one thing.
Human? You think he's human?
He's clothed. He stood upright. What other conclusion could you draw?
Large lower canine teeth, exaggerated musculature, extensive facial and body hair. An animal.
But with anthropomorphic features.
Even if you're right, we'd have to do a complete cellular analysis to determine his DNA code. And we don't have that kind of equipment here.
We don't need it. Yet. We run all the preliminary tests first and compile a body of knowledge.
Why wait? Why not issue a public statement right now? Tomorrow, we could have the entire scientific community at our feet.
I can't risk it.
What's at risk?
Jonathan, don't you see? It could happen again. They could take him away. Steal my work. The benefit of my research. Like they did before.
He's ours, Professor. And we will will decide what to do with him. Remember that.
Telling you he spoke the name of a woman, Catherine.
It's probably mimicry. He heard the name somewhere and learned to reproduce it.
But the cortical areas of his brain are developed enough for language.
If what you're saying is true, why doesn't he speak now and explain himself?
He's disoriented.
And dangerous. Who knows the extent of his strength?
Don't.
We have to keep him sedated.
He has intelligence, Jonathan.
You're romanticizing him. We don't know that.
I'm telling you, he's not what you think.
Oh, what? You think he fell from the sky?
Jonathan!
Change your mind?
More like second thoughts.
I just thought I'd come by on my way to work, find out for myself what's what, so I don't have to rely on nasty rumors.
Well, I'm still here.
I noticed.
You want some coffee? I just made a fresh pot.
Yeah, long as it's the real thing. That decaf makes me nervous. So, who's this Benson?
A friend.
Does this friend have anything to do with these second thoughts you're having?
Sort of.
You want to talk about it?
Not especially.
Now, don't give me a hard time about that. I only read that to keep up with the soaps for my aunt. She's deaf.
Possibly be that naive, Professor.
What do you mean?
When the research is completed and the article's published, what do you think happens then?
I won't allow it.
There won't be any choice.
When you first introduced yourself to me, you said you were only interested in the truth.
Yes.
Well, there it is. Why do you insist on perverting and degrading it?
The truth isn't meant to be hoarded like a secret.
Nor is it meant to be twisted and exploited. Yes, the creature is extraordinary and should be shared, but only when we know what we're dealing with first.
I'll tell you what we're dealing with. The freak of nature. A genetic accident. You saw what he was capable of.
He was provoked.
You really believe this thing has a conscience, don't you? Well, for his sake, I hope you're wrong. For his sake, I hope he's an imbecile. Because like it or not, the world's about to make a circus act out of him.
Where are you going?
You and I made a deal, Professor. Now it's time to see it through.
Please!
Out of my way, Hughes.
I won't let you do this!
Ask the bloody doorman. Of course he'll tell you. For $2,000, he damn well better tell you.
Excuse me, are you Byron Trask?
Yes, I am.
I'm Catherine Chandler with the District Attorney's Office.
See my editor or my lawyer, but leave me alone. I'm busy.
Wait a minute. You don't understand. I'm not here for that. Did it happen?
It's there in black and white, isn't it? Miss Chandler, we may not be the New York Times, but we are a newspaper. Did you know that this morning at the Bronx Zoo, an orangutan saved his keeper from choking on a bagel by applying the Heimlich maneuver? Now, where do you think an orangutan learned the Heimlich maneuver? Television. It's the truth. It's a whole truth and nothing but the truth.
Did you believe this woman? This Anna Lausch that you mentioned?
It's my job to believe her.
Did you believe her?
I've come to know the old woman quite well. She's what you might call a voyeur. But she's not a liar.
I need to talk to her.
Better than the movies. You would be surprised the things you see. If you sit here long enough. Winnie knows, don't you, Winnie? With this, I can see all over the park. Many different people. I look down on all of them. Here, try for yourself.
No, thank you.
Go on. Did you know I once saw Greta Garbo? She was walking.
Mrs. Lausch, I need to know what you saw that night.
the night. I watch the night, too. When the noises hush like children. And on come the street lamps. And the people of the dark.
Mrs. Lausch, try to remember. What did you see?
Two men were running. And a truck was following. With a bright light. Fast. And they go down by the tunnel. And the man turns. And I see his face. A terrible animal face. With such pain. And then the other man in the truck, he comes. And he...
He what?
Shoots at him.
Could you show me where?
There.
Thank you.
You will come back to see us, won't you?
Speak to me, please. I know you can, I heard you. You've got to let me help you.
Then release me.
So you can't speak. And you can understand what I say. Why did you keep silent in front of Gould?
The other man means me harm. No words could change that.
I never meant you harm. You must believe that. Do you have a name?
Vincent.
Vincent. My name is Hughes. I have so many questions. You spoke the name Catherine. Who is Catherine?
She's everything. But she lives. Only in my heart.
Is she like you? Another of your kind?
There is only me.
Vincent. What are you?
I am only what I am. If you cut me, I will bleed. If you strike me, I will strike back. And if you keep me in chains, I will die. forgive me.
I don't know what to do.
Let me go.
I can't. Not now, not yet. I still have so many unanswered questions.
You. I'm dying.
Leave me alone.
Professor Hughes?
Who is it?
My name is Catherine Chandler. Please, may I speak with you?
Catherine.
Thank you.
How can I help you?
I traced the serial number through the supplier in Albany to the university, and then to you. He's here, isn't he? Is he alive?
He's spoken of you.
Take me to him.
I can't do that. I'm sorry.
Please.
I need time. Everything's happening too quickly. There's more at stake here than you think.
No, there is only Vincent. If you've spoken with him, I know you understand that.
My whole career, my reputation, the respect of my colleagues.
Is that worth the pain he must be suffering?
There's still so much to learn from him, so much we don't know.
Who gave you the right?
It's too late. Don't you understand? Another man's already seen it.
Professor Hughes, I don't know how to explain this to you. I don't even pretend to understand it. But Vincent and I are connected. I know him. And I know that whatever he is, he's also the best part of what it means to be human. And if you take away his freedom, then you take away that very part that makes him most human.
Take it.
He's not going anywhere. Give me the key.
No.
Give me the key.
No.
Give me the key. No.
Listen to me, will you?
We've gone too far, Hughes. Both of us.
You don't understand.
He does speak.
Give me the key.
Oh. I'm sorry, Jonathan, but I can't allow you to do this.
Not now. Not what we know. No. We are.
Away, far away.
I will.
I wish I could have known him better. Vincent.
How could I forget thee? Through what power, even for the least division of an hour, have I been so beguiled as to be blind to my most grievous loss? That thought's return was the worst pang that sorrow ever bore, save one, one only. When I stood forlorn, knowing my heart's best treasure was no more, that neither present time nor years unborn could to my sight that heavenly face restore.